Welcome back to Cliffhangers of Arcadia Legends, where we will now find out what Enrique was up to. Well, Alfonso's on a power trip. So, now we have a guilder in the party. Let's equip him with some stuff. He has no armor. We'll give him a radiant fur for now, but we may have something better. Maybe we'll buy him some better stuff in the shop. Super moves. Blocking adverse effects is good at least. Oh. Hey, Aika. Yeah, we're not going there just yet. Let's go inside. Yeah. Can cause instant death? Yes, please. Damn it. Okay. Make sure we have one of those on hand. Okay, so those are good for magic defense and quickness goes down. I think I'll just get two of these. Yeah, that's overall, that's better for Fina. Magic defense goes down. Improves defense, though, and protects the wearer from adverse effects. That's just better overall. I like the idea of protecting from adverse effects, though. But at the same time... Yeah, you know what? Let's go with this for a bit, first of all. Okay, I've got to be careful here. The mining arm is the one I want to get rid of. Okay. Oh, vengeance armor. There's a lot of vengeance armor here. Let's have a little look and see. Vice the hero. Oh yeah, he dropped his vengeance armor. Let's sell two of them. because we may want to we may want to give Drachma and Enrique one when they come back to our party. Oops, spoilers. Remember we picked that up in the in deep sea, in the vortex. He will now start working on the finest weapons possible. Ew. That's a very short story, Alchemist. We've been standing here a while talking. Why are you saying hello? Out on those. Let's get another 15 of those. Another 12 of those. There doesn't seem to be a glyph of might that has the same ability as Incremus. We only really have Increm. But that's fine. Ooh, you got some seeds as well. I've got some that I can. Apparently, I have one I can use. Alright. Could use those to really overpower my party. But I don't think I will. Right, well. Yeah, not really anything I want to use. Sorry, Osman. Well, now that that's all done, let's go to the Great Silver Shrine. One hell of a craft. Keep holding on there, Vice. I can't even see Crescent Isle. Pretty sure we shouldn't be able to breathe. Do not adjust your set, folks. We are indeed upside down in space. Okay. Okay, I noticed the recording actually kind of crapped out there. When we went through that teleporter, what you didn't see was the emulator locked up for a little bit, and then we had a cutscene briefly telling us roughly where we had to go. Now the problem is, I can use the first person view, but I can't rotate the camera anymore. Basically, we got a big maze ahead of us, and the controls are super clunky. So, now the good news is, there's no mobs here. I do have a bit of a walkthrough in front of me, so you know. Okay, so I continue this way. Gravity is all weird and the controls have gotten all weird and clunky. I can't rotate the camera. Okay, I was not where I wanted to go. Okay, now the good thing is I'm going to be keeping a tab on what there is here. There are two pieces of armor and two moonberries. So. One piece of armor. It's not that good. They're just selling fodder, I guess. I've got really vague, and it just says things like continue until Vice is right side up again. It doesn't actually tell you where to go to get to being right side up. There's one moonberry. Okay, I'm right side up. Okay, ignore the route split. Favor the rising path, which culminates in an elevator. There's a second moonberry chest underneath the elevator's landing. reached by staying topside of the next bifurcation. Who the hell uses words like bifurcation in a walkthrough? What the Christ even is a bifurcation? That's the chest. I'm so glad there's no monsters here. Stay. Is bifurcation a junction? So I stay topside. Right. Okay. I bet whoever had to actually design and build this this dungeon probably went crazy. I'm going crazy just looking at it. Okay, well, we've looted the dungeon. So I believe we just follow this path around. I don't get how anyone's supposed to work this out. You can't get a good enough vantage point. And this is where we need to go. Into the Matrix. Get used to that humming noise, by the way. It's going to be here a while. Clearly, this is the reason why. We'll see. What? And they've clearly lost their minds a little bit. This hum probably has something to do with it. It is kind of torturous. Thank you. Man, they don't even deny it. Straight up, yeah, we're genocidal maniacs. Feels a bit Phantasy Star-ish. Also, the frame rate's taking a nosedive. I do apologize. Gilder seems okay. Here we go. Hi, Arachnum. I'd call you by your real name, but I can't remember what it is. Hi, Grendel. Jolly Green Giant. Yalagar. Can't remember. Blue one. Blueheim. I don't know what the red one was called either. Yeah, we'll see what the Gigas can do first hand. We've taken them out. The world was cleansed of evil, except for the people who decided that destroying the world was a good thing to do. Recognize a pattern on that island? And back to the crappy frame rate. Sorry, folks. They've gone mad. Gee, what do you think the right answer is going to be? Things have all kind of gone a bit south, really. What does it really matter? Whether Ramirez is the one who does it, or you guys. This is what you wanted. We'll get a teleport, but in case this screws up the capture, I'm going to leave it now. When we next pick up, we'll be on the other side of the teleport. Thanks very much for watching, folks. See you next episode. Goodbye.